Are y'all ready to praise and lift up the name of Jesus? Listen, I'm ready. I hope you're ready. Come on and clap your hands this morning. Get in a grateful place. Just think about all the wonderful things that God has done, but not just what he's done, but for who he is. So we're going to lift up a praise this morning, y'all. Let's go. Here we go. Listen. Oh, Lord. We praise you, oh Lord, we praise you, oh Lord, we praise you, oh Lord, we praise you. Everybody say, oh Lord, we praise you. It's simple, y'all. Oh Lord, we praise you, oh Lord, we praise you. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Listen, I was thinking the other day about the joy that came my way, how you took away my crown and all the things that had me bound. I thought about all those times that I was walking around in a daze. Today I stand before you with nothing but praise. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Everybody say, oh, Lord, we praise you. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Take us higher. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Everybody say, oh, Lord, we praise you. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Take it higher. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Yes, we do, Lord. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Listen, I was thinking the other day about the joy came my way, how you took away my crown and all the things that had me down. I thought about all those times that I was walking around in days. And today I stand before you with nothing but praise, oh Lord. Oh Lord, we praise you. 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 Hallelujah. 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 We give you the praise. We give you the glory. We give you the honor. We bless your name this morning. Because you're worthy of all the glory and all the honor. And so we take ourselves out of the way. And we say, I give myself away. This song simply is a sign of us surrendering. Hallelujah, God. Thank you, Lord. It says, I give myself away. Lift it up if you know it. Thank you, Jesus. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me. Here I am, here I stand. Lord, my life is in your hands. Lord, I'm longing to see your desire revealed in me. I give myself away. Let's surrender this morning, our all, y'all. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. I make myself available to you. I give myself away so you can use me. So here I am, here I stand. And Lord, my life is in your hands. Lord, I am longing to see your desire revealed in me. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. Here I am, Lord. Give myself away so you can use me. You can use me. Listen, my life is in your hands. To you I belong. I give myself to you. Life is not my own. To you I belong. Yeah, I give myself to you. Come on, let's sing it together. My life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself to you. Life is not my own, yeah. To you I belong. I give myself to you. So I give myself away. Oh, I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. I give myself away so you can use me. And I surrender all.
Hey, good morning, virtual followers and friends. Yet again, we thank you for tuning in for the NMC experience this morning. We're glad that you come back to share with us as we continue to worship God in spirit and in truth. Listen, do me a favor. I need you to type down in that comment field, God is good. I'm so grateful to be before you this morning to share with you what God has shared with me. I try my best not to be before you too long, probably about 2 hours, and I'll let you go. But God has gratefully been so great in my life, and I believe he's been great in your life. And so we want to just talk with you today on a couple of things and share with you the goodness of a good shepherd. And we want to move on from there. But listen, we just want to just take a couple of seconds in silence as we commemorate and look back over the 20 years that we celebrated on yesterday for those on the September 11 attack. So if you don't mind with me, just a couple of moments of silence. Amen. Listen, I want you to turn your attention to the book of Psalms. Book of Psalms. We're going to look at a familiar verse. I was telling the bishop that I haven't preached from this psalm in a while, but I believe that there are some good nuggets in there. Go with me to Psalms 23. Truly grateful for all of our ministerial staff, all of our leadership staff. We thank God for all of our media team. We thank God for our music ministry. We thank God for each and every one of you. Psalms 23, thank God for Lady Baker and our family. Thank God for you and your families. Psalm 23. I promise you, if you just stick with me this morning, I won't be before you too long. Listen, Psalm 23. This is what David says to us. Psalm 23, first verse. The Lord is my shepherd. That's all I want to talk about. And if you would, just type down in the comment field, the Lord is. The Lord is. God bless you this morning. I had a couple of moments. If you all just allow me to just preach it how I feel. I had a couple of moments where I was able to look at a couple of interviews, a couple of videos, a couple of films, footage, what took place on September the 11th. I got a better understanding of what took place, because you have to understand that what took place on September the 11th, it was different events that led up to September the 11th. The attack on America's soil began somewhere outside of America. The attack that took place on September the 11th, 2001, it was arranged by individuals that did not live in our country. As we all know some of the history of it, this was part of a religious war as well. For years, man has been warring against each other when it comes to religion. I believe my God, you believe your God. There are some that will die for what they believe in. There are some that will call themselves martyrs and that will even take others' lives for they believe that what they're doing is the right thing to do. September 11th, some of you can probably recall where you were on that day. I'll never forget it. I was working at Nextel and calls started coming through and people started chattering, but I didn't know the magnitude of what happened. I heard about it. I said, oh, okay, some planes hit a building. And I kind of went on about my way. It wasn't until later until I'm driving and the radio stations are, you can hear the darkness in the radio host voice. You turn on every channel, you can hear it in the media. There was a dark gloom that had went over America. That particular day, ladies and gentlemen, four planes landed in four different destinations. But even though they landed in four different destinations, the planes may have landed in destinations, but the pain landed all over America. All over America. Almost 3,000 lives lost and taken because of a coward act. I mean, you think about it. Individuals jumping out of buildings because they had no other options, and people losing their lives, even first responders who was not in the building but were trying to go back in the building to help others. Some lost their lives because they didn't see it coming. Then some lost their lives because they were trying to go in and help individuals to save some lives. Oh, brothers and sisters, it was a horrible day for America. But thank be to God. Thank be to God that we serve a good shepherd. And the Lord, in the midst of these 20 years, have been able to somewhat start to rebuild America's hope back, build America's structure back, build America's faith back, build some reuniting with Americans. And in the midst of all of this, brothers and sisters, can I tell you that the Lord is still good? And in the midst of buildings collapsing, it's hard to see. Because some would say, what kind of God would allow something like this to happen? But can I tell you that God is still good? Can I tell you, in the midst of all of this, it's hard to even fathom how can a God we say that we serve could allow such mass destructions and things to take place in our country and outside of our country. Suicide bombers. How could God allow these things to happen? Brothers and sisters, I want to tell you that even though it shook America on 9/11, I want to tell you, don't let it shake your faith. I want to tell you to still keep your faith in the God that we serve, because as David reminded us in his psalm, that the Lord is still a good shepherd. In the midst of 9/11, that may have not been the attack on your life, but all of us have had some attacks to go on in our lives. Oh, if you would just be honest this morning, you've had some attacks. It may have not been in New York. It may not have been at the Pentagon. But some of you have had some attacks right there at your address. Oh, y'all don't want to be real with me this morning. Some of you may have not been at the buildings. But some of you have had attacks in your marriage. Some of you have had attacks in your family. Some of you have had attacks in your finances, attacks in your health. But can somebody shout with me this morning and just type down in the comment field, the Lord is still good. Oh, brothers and sisters, quickly as I sum this thing up for you, the Bible is teaching us through the 23rd Psalm that the Lord is a good shepherd. For the very first verse, this is what David mentions. David says, the Lord is my shepherd. Can I just attest with you, if things are going to happen good in our life, the very first thing that we have to do is acknowledge God as our shepherd. David acknowledges God as his Lord. For he says, and he makes it personal, he says, the Lord is my shepherd. Can I talk to some of you this morning that could just be honest, and you had to make sure that you had a personal relationship with God? For when David talks in here, he did not say the Lord is our shepherd. He did not say that the Lord is your shepherd. But David says this has to be personal. I have to know how good God is for myself. So David says, the Lord is my shepherd. Can I just give y'all a few seconds to be selfish this morning? Type down in the comment field that the Lord is mine. The Lord is my shepherd. He goes on to say, and I'm reading from the Christian Standard Bible. He says, the Lord is my shepherd. Number one, he goes ahead and announces his relationship with God. But secondly, watch this. He says, I have everything that I need. Woo. He says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Not only does he understand his relationship with God, but he understands his resources from God. Somebody ought to shout, God is my resources. He says, the Lord is my shepherd. He understands that the first thing is not asking from God, but understanding to have a relationship with God. And some of us, the reason why we can't understand how good God is because we're too busy asking God from things rather than having a relationship with God. We're too busy wanting things from God, but not busy working on our relationship with God. We're too busy wanting blessings from God, but not too busy building our relationship with God. We're too busy asking God to do things in our family, but we're not busy enough building our relationship with God. David says, my relationship with God is number one. When he says, the Lord is my shepherd, he said, number two, I shall not want. He says, because watch this, the Lord is my shepherd, I have everything that I need. Oh, brothers and sisters, when you make the Lord your shepherd, you may not have everything that you want, but God has a way of supplying everything that you need. Understand something, we look at this picture because here it is. It paints a picture of a shepherd and sheep. And when you look at the shepherd and a sheep in Mid-Eastern countries, what they would do is when the shepherd would have the sheep, they did not stay in areas for long periods of time. They would have to take these sheep and they would continuously move. And Sister Bree, the reason why they would continuously move is because the longer they would stay in one area, it would put the sheep in harm's way. Oh, can I just stop and tell you, sometimes God has to relocate you. He has to remove you from some areas, remove you from some friendships, remove you from some things, because where you currently are, it may hurt you. I wish I had some people to understand. Sometimes the shepherd knows that if he keeps you in one pasture, that pasture is going to harm you. He understands that if he leaves you in certain relationships, it's going to harm you. He understands that if he leaves you at certain companies, is going to harm you. I wish y'all would come here with me, about five of y'all, and shout this morning, God, remove me. Remove me from whatever pasture that is not healthy from me. Because the shepherd had to remove the sheep for certain pastures because of different diseases that can take places. Can I tell you the reason why some of your life is going the way it is? Because you've been in certain pastures for too long. Go shout with me this morning. I think I feel like preaching about two more hours. Here it is. If you just learn how to hear the shepherd's voice, because what the shepherd would do is walk along with the sheep. Walk along with the sheep long enough and the sheep will learn to hear the shepherd's voice. And when the shepherd would move, the sheep would follow. Can I tell you, sometimes you're stuck somewhere that God ain't no more. Sometimes you're in relationships that God don't approve no more. Sometimes you're stuck in ministries that God told you to leave a long time ago. Sometimes you're stuck somewhere that God ain't even, come on, somebody help me say, is the shepherd still in it? Ooh. Has a shepherd, because a shepherd uses a rod and staff. Look what the text says, the Lord is my shepherd. Number one, I have everything I need, I shall not want. He lets me lie down in green pastures. Ooh. Ain't it good to know that the shepherd will put you in places, watch this, of prosperity. Ooh. I like a prosperous God. He says he allows me to lie down in green pastures. And in other words, the sheep was able to be in a place that they could be fed. They was able to be in a place where they could be safe and they could be healthy. The shepherd knows where to place you. I like the shepherd, because the shepherd knows to put him in green pastures. And watch this. Not only does the shepherd put his sheep in green pastures. Not only will God put you in great places, not only will God put you in healthy relationships, not only will God put you in a good career. Now look what the shepherd does. The shepherd puts the sheep in green pastures. You probably saying, well, God, well, Quinn, why am I in the places I am? Was it the shepherd that put you there? Oh, man, come on, y'all talk to me. You probably saying, how did I get in this marriage? Was it God who told you to marry him or her? You probably saying, what am I doing on this job? Who told you to take that job? When the shepherd is involved, the shepherd lies the sheep in green pastures. Y'all talk with me this morning, but you're probably saying, my pasture don't look too green. Maybe it wasn't the shepherd that put you there. Says, here it is, lies down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. That word still interpreted as quiet. The reason why God will lead you, it's because you understand that sheep were not some smart animals. Sheep were animals that needed some direction. Just like us, we need God's direction. We need to hear the voice of God. We need God's word. We need a path set before us. The shepherd would lead the sheep to quiet waters. Paul's saying, what's the significance of quiet waters? Because sheep were afraid of running waters. So the shepherd would have to lead them to the water because the sheep had to feel comfortable with going into different places that they had never been before. Can I help y'all? And sometimes we're so stuck into our traditional mindsets. We're so stuck into certain ways. But can I tell you, the shepherd will always lead you into some better places. Woo. The shepherd will always lead you, watch this, to some still waters. And sometimes there's so much going on in your life, so much noise going on in your life, so much ruckus and chaos going on in your life. You need to just ask the Lord to lead me to some quiet waters. Quiet the mess in my family. Quiet the mess in my life. Quiet the mess in the White House. Quiet the mess in the government. Quiet the mess in the school systems. Somebody shine quiet, God. You need God to lead you to some still waters. I'm almost done. I can't get through it all today, but he says he leads me beside still waters. He renews my life. He leads me along the path of righteousness for his name's sakes. Even when I go through the darkest valley. Can I just share with you, care how saved you are this morning, all of us are going to have some valley experiences. I don't care how much you tithe or how much you give. I don't care how many times you speak in tongues, how many times you lay out on the altar, how many times you preach, how many times you pray, how many times you pull up at the church, how many times you watch it on Zoom, or how many times you watch it on Facebook and YouTube. I don't care if you read this version of the Bible, you read your version, Paul's version, Tony's version. I don't care how much word you have. All of us will go through some valley experiences. I wish I had some real talkers out there this morning, but the good thing about valley experiences is that we have a shepherd that will walk with us. I wish I had two or three of us that said, I'm glad that when I went through some valley experiences, I had a shepherd that would walk with me and a shepherd that will talk with me. Y'all shout with me this morning. How many of you know that the shepherd will walk with you? How many know that the shepherd will talk with you? How many know that the shepherd will be with you? You ought to shout down in the comment field, I'm glad to know the shepherd. Shepherd, watch this. Number one, he says, the Lord is my shepherd. Relationship says, I shall not want resources. Oh, I love a good shepherd. Brothers and sisters, I can't get through it all this morning, but I'm glad to know that, watch this, not only would he remove the sheep out of places for making sure that they stay healthy, he will relocate the sheep, put them in different pastures, but put them in green pastures. Green suggests that it was healthy. It was vibrant. You know, some of you are having lives, your life ain't vibrant no more. There's no energy about your life. You know, some people they say they love God, they got all this joy, but you're always pitiful. But the good shepherd will put you in green pastures. He restores my soul. He says, no, I just, even when I go through the darkest valley, I fear no danger. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. I'll come back next week and deal with these tables. But can I just deal with you for the rod and staff for a minute? The shepherd would use a rod and a staff because it was easier for the shepherd to reach sheep that was further away from him. Oh boy, this is that goodness, that's that grace of God. Because you got to understand that all the sheep went as close as some other sheep. I can hear that old sheep over there. Y'all be with me in the picture just a minute. You know, you got sheep in your family that's mad that you closer to the shepherd. That, oh, y'all don't want to hear me. Some folk jealous with you because you just a little bit closer to the shepherd than they are. But can I just tell you that they all were still in the same area? But what the shepherd would do sometimes, if one would start to weird off and go into a wrong direction, he would take his staff and pull him back into the path. Can I talk to some people this morning? You got to be thankful of God's grace. Because even when you went off in the wrong directions, even when you made some decisions you shouldn't have made, even when you said some things, God just have a way of taking the staff and just pulling you back in. Aren't you glad that God pulled you back in with some of the cussing that you did? I know y'all don't cuss. I'm just talking about, hey man, the two or three of us that use some words sometimes we shouldn't have used. Now, I know y'all don't say nothing bad. I'm talking about cussers. I ain't talking about y'all. I'm just talking about the folks who don't say some things, that don't did some stuff, don't drunk too much, went places, and God still pulled you back in. It was simply because of God's grace and his mercy that he extends his love to his sheep. Can I talk to you? And I'm done. How many of you can say, I love a good shepherd who in the midst of all of my life, all of my wrongdoings, all of my things I've done, he's had a tendency of pulling me back in. Oh, brothers and sisters, the Lord is. Somebody shout, the Lord is. Hey, brothers, I'm done with you this morning. But how many are glad that the Lord is able to pull you back in even when you start going off? I can see the sheep. Can you see them out there? Somebody say, bad. I'm just having fun now. I can see them out there, bad. Just out there being sheep. Just looking around. Just being amongst each other. And you know the sad thing about sheep? You know the sad thing about people? All the sheep out there smelt a certain kind of way. They all were eating the same thing. They all was, ain't it sad that we become so critical of each other, not understanding that we all got something that we deal with? All the sheep was out there smelling like sheep, looking like sheep, and had an audacity to be bad in each other. Can I just tell you, ain't that how life is? All of us got something we deal with, but somehow everybody always criticizing each other. Can I just tell you, what you need to do is be sheep and just try to stick close to the shepherd. I'm done with you. God bless you real good this morning. Listen, we'll come back next week. We're going to deal with tables. For the fifth verse says, you prepare a table for me in the presence of my enemies. We love shouting about, you know, the enemy part, but we got to deal with sheep. And as sheep, we need to be led by the shepherd. Listen, God bless you this Sunday morning. I pray you have a good day. But just remember, the Lord is. God bless you. Peace.
Come on, put your hands together as we get ready to leave today. I hope you enjoyed the message. Oh, God blessed you. I want you to put your hands together and dance a little bit with me. Come on. To the left. To the right. Come on. Hey. To the left. To the right. Come on. Take it back. To the. Come on. Take it back. Come on. To the left. Listen. If